Citizen Television.
Greetings and welcome to another episode of the Planetary Persuader. Hello, I am Cosmic Kev, your host, and this is for the week beginning with Friday, the 6th of October, extending to October 12th. So, what's going on this week? Well, I want to just recap what happened last week, because that was just enough. We just recently had Saturn just went into Scorpio, and that happened on, that happened just earlier this morning, I believe. If I am not mistaken. And so, with Saturn now in Scorpio, rather this afternoon, depending on where you live, we had Saturn in Libra was rather exalted. Now, Saturn in Scorpio is not great. You know, it depends on who you are and where it goes. Saturn in Scorpio, it puts limits on our ability to procreate. It puts limits on our ability to be creative, to be fertile. And in a way, it's like, it's almost like you have to have planned sex or plan your birth. Your art that you're doing, you got to do it a little bit slower. This is your potency in slow motion. We're calling it Saturn in Scorpio. All right. So the other thing is that, you know, in a way you associate it with death. Saturn is kind of like the Grim Reaper to begin with. And Scorpio has sex, birth, and death. So there's limits to all of it. And, you know, in some ways it could be a death to death. You know, depending on where your moon sign is, especially when Saturn passes by your moon, it can be very, very depressing. Saturn passing by your sun's no picnic either. Venus is in Virgo. That was good news. You know, Venus in Virgo makes us want to be naked sun worshippers. And here on the West Coast, we have that Indian summer thing happening this year. So it's been very warm, and you know, the swimming's still good, the sunbathing's still great, as long as you're not in the fog belt. And other news is that Jupiter went retrograde this week. So we got Jupiter at 16 degrees Gemini, it just went station retrograde. So in a lot of ways, our good fortune that was in some ways moving ahead, and there were expansions in the field of communication and travel, those things are kind of have to slow down. They all have to halt. And we have to internalize in our own minds what a spiritual message is to us. You know, one thing I would say about Jupiter retrograde, instead of petitioning your creator or praying to God, why don't you try listening to your creator? Listen to God. Just be quiet. Don't say anything. Don't ask for anything. Listen. And, if you do need to have one prayer, it says, you know, it might be just, I want to be spiritually sensitive so I can understand what it means to listen to the voice of the Almighty or the Creator. It might work. I don't know. Some people have experiences, some people don't. So it's okay. Whatever happens, it's okay. I know it's kind of like an experiment. And let's see, what other goody-goodies do we have? Well, Mercury goes into Scorpio as well. So we have this sort of Scorpio energy, and yet one thing changes. One thing gets less Scorpio, and that's Mars. Because Mars goes into Sagittarius. Of course, for us Jyotishis, you know, we know that Mars is still in Scorpio. You know, I mean, in a sense, you know, and that a lot of ways that Mars energy will intensify. So, what I think with the Sun in Libra is we're focused on relationships. what fairness means to us, what balance, what beauty, and what harmonizing means. Sometimes that can make us lazy. Sometimes that can make us very motivated because we want that right relationship. So let's see how this goes as we go sign by sign in this week's episode of The Planetary Persuader.